Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back after the break. You're watching Towards the Origin in conversation with Shaykh Kazi Lutfur Rahman, respected Imam and Khateeb of the famously known Mosque, Regent's Park Mosque. Our tonight's discussion is on the topic purification of soul. In the first segment, we did hear about the importance of the soul and how to purify, and inshallah, we'll continue our discussion in this segment. Now, Shaykh, before we move on to the other aspect of the purification of soul, whenever we discuss the subject purification of soul, we do also hear another word at the same time, ihsan.
Right.
Now, I'd like to find out, what does ihsan mean?
طيب بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Now, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he also spoke in a hadith about or regarding ihsan. Now, there is a huge connection between tazkiyatun nafs, purification of the soul, and ihsan, because they are actually similar meaning, or they carry the similar meanings. Noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and the hadith is actually the hadith al-Qudsi, the hadith of Jibreel Amin alayhi salam, very famous hadith. When he came and he started to ask Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Islam, what is the meaning of Islam, what is the meaning of Iman, and what is the meaning of Ihsan. Now, first thing he said, what is the meaning of Iman, or what is the meaning of Islam? So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Islam an ta'budallah wa la tushrika bihi shay'a. That Islam is that you're worshipping Allah alone without any partnership. Man ek Allah pak rabbul alaminer ibadat ebong bondegi kora. Kuno shorik unar sathe na kora. Wa tuqimus salah, and then you establish salah, wa tu'ti zakah, and then you give zakah, and all of those like five pillars of Islam. Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, what is iman? أي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إيمان كي تكون رسول الله كريم صلى الله عليه وسلم إيمان هو أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه you know إيمان is to faith is to believe in Allah and his messenger and his angels and his books all the articles of faith and then the final question was made by جبريل عليه السلام by saying وما الإحسان what is إحسان O Prophet of Allah and the noble messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم he replied by saying الإحسان أن تعبد الله كأنك ترى that you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you can see him মানে আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিন কে এমন ভাবে ইবাদত করো যে যেরকম তোমরা মানে দেখতে পারো না কে just a feeling তারপরে উনি বলছেন وَإِفَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ and if you couldn't see him then at least know that he is seeing you He's also seeing you. মানে এটা যদি তোমরা মানে আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামকে যদি না দেখতে পারো তখন অ্যাট লিস্ট এই অনুভবটা ভিতরের মধ্যে রাখো যে আল্লাহ পাক আপনার তোমাদেরকে দেখতেছেন সো নাও ওয়াই ইহসান ইজ এক্সপ্লেইন ও মেনশন ইন দিস ওয়ে মিন ইহসান মিনস এক্সেলেন্স Ihsan is another meaning, which is excellence. Meaning, আমরা যে জিনিসটা করবো এই পৃথিবীর মধ্যে উই গোনা বি ডুইং ইন এক্সেলেন্ট ওয়ে মানে সব থেকে পারফেকশন সব থেকে উত্তম সব থেকে ভালো পদ্ধতি আমরা এটা করবো তখন এবাদতটাও কিন্তু সব থেকে উত্তম পদ্ধতিতে হতে হবে এবং এটারই অর্থ হচ্ছে ইহসান
এবং আই ক্যান রিলেট দ্যাট টু দ্য ওয়ার্ল্ডলি ম্যাটার অ্যাজ ওয়েল হোয়েনেভার উই ট্রাই টু অ্যাচিভ সামথিং অর ট্রাই টু বি সাকসেসফুল আমাদের যদি প্রফেশনাল ওয়ার্ল্ড আমরা দেখি উই অলওয়েজ ট্রাই টু এক্সেল অ্যান্ড বি দি পারফেক্ট ইন দ্যাট ফিল্ড
ইয়েস
টু অ্যাচিভ আইদার দি নেক্সট পজিশন আপ হায়ার অর পারহ্যাপস
প্রমোশন অ্যান্ড অল দোজ লাইক ইউ নো গেটিং হায়ার
ইয়েস অল দ্য আদার বেনিফিট অ্যান্ড স্ট্যাটাস দ্যাট কামস উইথ ইট সো ওয়েন উই ক্যান স্ট্রাইভ অ্যান্ড স্ট্রাগল to do best in this world, what stops us from doing the best for
exactly.
our akhirah?
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our noble Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they want us to go to that stage where we can excel the ibadah and we can do the ihsan and ibadah and that's only can be possible and achieved while when we see that we are, or when we worship Allah, we worship, or we are seeing Allah and if we can't see, if we couldn't see Him, then at least He is seeing us.
Now one of the other thing I can relate that to our practical ibadah as well, when we see jokhon amra namaz puri, especially we do notice in the masajids that they have enough time in the world to do everything else. But when it comes to salah, that's one of the most express train
yes,
you can ever find.
Yes, and it's done very quickly. And there are people who would be actually there to tell, like, you know, finish, you know, there's no time, and like, you know, and sometimes people can complain.
Giving reminder to imams as well, today you're longer than usual.
Yes. And at the same time, we have some other people as well, they make their salah very lengthy as well.
Correct.
But they need to be a balanced approach, as we always say, i'tidal, and the timing, the position, the place, and all of the thing need to be considered when we obviously lead salah you know we have to see also the age group the situation of the
people
you know who may be disabled and people may be like unwell and all those kind of things
now the other thing you've mentioned about the Islam that believe in Allah and do not associate any partner now every one of us We know that in general.
Yep.
Practicing, non-practicing, or partially practicing, every one of us know that we can't do shirk. Now, there is another aspect to the shirk today. We see following an ideology.
Yep.
Following your fame, name, wealth.
Well,
now, how does that then...
We are actually coming to that part, but just before that, we have a little discussion. Inshallah, we'll come to this, the self-importance and fame and all of those things, which is connected to the inner dimension. Now, so we've been saying that ihsan anta abdullah kaannaka tara fa illam takun tara fa innahu yarak. But again, we have in human being and as Muslim and as believers, we have when we worship Allah, we have two major different types of worship, right? So number one, worshipping the external worship or the outward worship or the bajik je amra ibadat gula kore thaki, and the second one is the internal worship or the inward worship. Now you might ask, how do you do that? So let's just give some examples that can make things clear. Amra jokon Allah pak rabbul alamin ibadat kori, amra ibadat dui prokar hoye thake, abhyontoron ebong bajik. Bajik ibadat gulor moddhe amra jeta dekhte pacchi, jemon amra namaz jokon pori, namazer moddhe amra movement hocche, when we are moving around, we
make physical worship.
We can see, people can see, and this is just something that people can view and people can see. So this is something outward. Then we find something called Hajj. For example, when we go Hajj and we do the rituals of Hajj, and when we go around and when we do Tawaf, all of those things again can be seen. Then you see when people go again in the field of jihad, obviously in defensive mode, then again this also can be seen. Then also we find something called ad-da'wa ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you go in the field of da'wah and you give da'wah and you talk to people, you communicate, especially in public, again, that can be seen. So there are a range of ibadah that we do, and they're actually seen and they're viewed and they're outward, right? And just the way we have to excel the outward ibadah, right? The things that I've mentioned through learning, through education, through studying the fiqh, the Islamic law and jurisprudence, and tafsir and hadith. Similarly, we have another type of ibadah, and they're actually the inward or the ibadah that's connected to the inner dimension.
Okay, just to peter on record and for our benefit of our viewer, many people would not understand the term jihad, and the way we look at it in today's world, it perhaps can be mistranslated or misused. So it's not something that Islam advocates that anyone can do anything they want in the name of Islam. Let me just clarify it on record.
Yes, of course. First of all, the word jihad actually means struggle.
Striving and struggle.
Okay. But it has different degrees and different levels. And just the way people have some sort of right of defense, similarly, Islam has a defensive side as well. But that doesn't mean that people can do anytime or anywhere.
Without any leadership, without anything.
Study. And I think one of the biggest failure of our time is the lack of education in that fiqh, the fiqh of that subject of jihad. And it's really highly misinterpreted and
misused, misunderstood?
Misused by people as well. And it's given a very bad name.
Because in the current world that we live in, whenever someone hears the word jihad, they only think about it's fighting.
Yes.
But it could be, could be struggling with my job.
I have seen a book called Al-Jihad Al-Iqtisadi, the economical jihad. How many of us had actually the jihad in iqtisad, in economy? So al-jihad al-iqtisad is written by one of the scholars of Al-Azhar University. So we can find that jihad can take place in writing, in economy, in many different ways. It's just a whole entire struggle. But anyway, so having said that, now this can be, the purpose of mentioning the word was to say that this can be also seen. But now then there is another side of the worship, and that is the inward worship. Now whatever we're doing, ibadah, salah, hajj, rituals, all of those things, where is the intention? Because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said intention plays a vital role. And where is the place of intention? Now the scholars of Islam, they say mahallu niyyat al-qalb. So the place of intention is the heart and soul. Now how do I purify my intention? Now, I can't learn from this book, from the book of fiqh or book of tafsir or hadith. Again, this needs to be done through the tarbiyah, tarbiyatun nafs, tarbiyatun ruh, tarbiyat al-qalb, through the nurturing and through training and through the purification of the soul. And of course, we'll mention how that can be achieved. But this is one of the things, intention, something that can't be seen, but it plays an important role in the life of a Muslim. Then we've got something called, and Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَاتِ Actions are judged according to intention. And you have said as earlier, there are different types of shirk. And one of the types of shirk is riya. What is riya? Showing off. Like you're doing ibadah to be called a musalli. You are doing hajj so that you can be called hajj. You know, hajj sab.
Is there something called a shirk khafi and shirk jali?
Yeah, and that's the shirk khafi. Like, you know, shirk khafi.
What's the difference, if you can explain to us?
So shirk jali is something that's clear that you say Allah is not one.
And so khafi, clearly you're associating partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Yes. Okay. And the khafi is something that you do, according to my understanding, you do things for other than Allah. Allah pak rabbul alamin batitu unnunu manushter jonno ebong onno jinisher jonno ibadat bondegi kora.
For example,
when we come to some of us, like maybe we build the masjids.
Okay.
Now maybe some have a good intention of building the masjid so people can pray, sadaqa jariya, it's a continuous rewards until yawm al-qiyamah. But some may want some sort of name, so haji umuk miya masjid. Right?
Okay.
In a so-and-so person masjid. Now, this is not wrong. A name can be given for the remembrance and for the purpose of dua. But if the intention behind that is to be famous, to achieve the fame and name, then that's,
In other words, some people brag about, oh, I've donated this, I've made that tubo, I've donated
this, I've made
the village. And they call, even we've seen on record, people are boasting. I mean, not necessarily that they might be boasting intentionally, how it might be perceived as they're boasting about what they have done.
Yeah, and that's again wrong. And even if after giving charity and any kind of favor to people, it is wrong and it is not allowed actually to give some sort of like a man. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Noble Quran that, you know, the people who give charity and do favors, and then they speak about it. This is a wrong thing.
Now, to put things in context, amra dekhi ajke jodi keu ekjon shofolota orjon kore, we would straight away find out, oh, I've helped him to achieve this success.
And some people didn't even do it, but they want to take the credit.
Credit, correct.
Have you seen that?
Yes.
Like, I have done this to this person. I've done this favor to that person. They probably have never done anything. But when somebody become like Allah takes them to some positions, then some people start taking the credit. Okay. And I can tell, like, one of the examples, like, is আমাদের মধ্যে যদি কোনো ব্যক্তি মানে খুব অর্থনৈতিকভাবে সামাজিকভাবে উন্নতি অর্জন করতে পারেন, সফলতা অর্জন করতে পারেন, অনেক লোক বলতে শুরু করে যে উনি তো আমার বন্ধু.
Correct.
You know, he's my friend.
Oh, I know him.
I know him. Yeah. But when you go and ask the person, do you know that person? They say, no, I've never heard of him. Or I don't know him. Everybody's claiming to be some sort of connection.
It's the culture that we live in, that if you are associated with people who are famously known within the circle, or have got a certain esteem or certain status in the society, you might, perhaps it's seen that you can also lift your status up a little bit in the society.
Yes. And I normally say, I have heard from a very great scholar of Islam saying that, you know, the fame is a disease, right? Like, you want always the fame and name and profile, right? He said, right, no matter how much famous you become in this world, there will be still people don't know you. মানে আপনি যত বিখ্যাত হয়ে যান, যত সুখ্যাত হয়ে যান, কিন্তু এই পৃথিবীর মধ্যে কিছু লোক থাকবে আপনাকে চিনে না. There are people like the most famous people I have asked when I sometime go to some other parts of the world, like when I even went to go to Bangladesh. I asked, do you know this person? He's very famous. I said, no, we've never heard of him.
And not only that.
And they meant to be the most famous people in the world.
Now, not only that, but also, আমাদেরকে একটু মনে রাখতে হবে, এই যাদেরকে আমরা আজকে দেখছি Facebook, Instagram, and all the other social media network, they might have millions of people following them. But মারা যাওয়ার পরে পরের বছর কিন্তু কেউ স্মরণ করে না.
That's right. And not only that, and that also, like, we can prove ourselves, or we can establish the fame that we have when we go to Hajj, for example, or Umrah. Who knows you there? You see, though, no matter how famous you are, believe me, you can just try. মানে আমরা আমাদেরকে একটু এক্সপেরিমেন্ট করে দেখি. যখন আমরা হাজের ময়দানে যাই, যখন আমরা কিন্তু একটা বিশাল কোনো একটা ইজতেমার মধ্যে যাই, বড় একটা ময়দানে যাই, তখন আমাদের নিজেদেরকে দেখতে পারি যে আসলে আমরা কত ফেমাস, আমাদেরকে কতজন লোক চেনে. So really, there's no need. And I know the people who don't want to become famous, they're the most probably famous people in the world, because they don't want fame. But Allah gives. So it's just something that, you know, when you avoid, Allah gives it to you.
Then it needs to be understood in context. Fame itself is not bad, but it's how you deal with it,
so fame,
or how you acquire it.
Not only that, it's not that we something aim to achieve, but if it comes, Prophet ﷺ is the most famous
individual.
He is the most famous, you know, because of his action, because of his achievement, because of his contribution for the Ummah and for humanity. He's the most famous person. Now, so fame is not something wrong, but it should not be the aim of an individual in life.
Now, ekhon bhalo kaj korte gele, we are doing a lot of selfies, we are doing self-promotion, marketing,
and as I said,
it,
I have seen the most academic people, those who utilize each and every single minute of their life, they don't do these things. Honestly. Now, our time is coming. So we've got things like sincerity, which is inner dimension, part of the soul. Patience, patience is something that's inside and we can't see the patience. So if someone says, where is your patience? Show me. I can't see. Again, it is something that a safer and quality of the soul. Then the scholar said, tawakkul, the trust in Allah. The ultimate trust. Nowadays, people don't have trust in Allah. Something minor happens, people start running around to the surgery and doctors, which is, of course, important. But people never have any kind of reliance on Allah. There's no tawakkul. And Prophet ﷺ said, whenever a musibah is to come, whenever a calamity would touch Prophet ﷺ, he would go and make dua and pray salah first. So tawakkul in Allah, again, it's part of the soul. Then we have something called generosity, the ikram, being kind, feeding people. And Prophet ﷺ said very clearly that al-yadul ulya khayrun min yadi sufla. The hand, upper hand, is better than the upper hand, is better than the lower hand. The hand which gives is better than the hand which takes. Again, generosity is highly rewarding. There are people in our society, they just want to take and they just want to eat and they never want to feed. মানে আমাদের মধ্যে কিছু কিছু লোক রয়ে গেছেন যে ওনারা সবসময় খেতেই চান কিন্তু অন্যদেরকে খাওয়াতে চান না কিন্তু ওয়ান অফ দ্য কোয়ালিটিস অফ আ সালেহীন অফ দ্য পিপল অফ সালাহ অ্যান্ড তাকওয়া অ্যান্ড স্পিরিচুয়ালিটি ইজ দে উড ফিড পিপল সো again part of the inner dimension modesty haya Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said ila idha lam tastahi fasna' ma shi'd. If you don't have modesty then you can do whatever you like. Nowadays people don't have much haya, and haya is a great quality not only just in women but also in men. Some people they just think haya is for women only. No, haya is also for men, and both men and women have to acquire the quality of haya, the modesty. Then we've got the humbleness again, tawadhu lillah, the humbleness for Allah. Prophet ﷺ said, "Man tawadhu lillah rafa'ahu Allah." Whoever humbles himself or herself for the sake of Allah, Allah raises his or her status. Then we've got stuff like khushu', concentration in salah. All of these things are part of our inner soul dimension. And now, as I said, just the way we have to excel the outward ibadah, we have to excel inward ibadah. Now, this is the part and this is the job of the soul. And just the way we have good qualities of the soul, there are also bad qualities of soul. For example, riya, the showing of, the look dekhano. As we said, fame, self-importance. So we have got this problem and disease of self-importance. Fame, name, riya, the pride and arrogance, Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, إِنَّ مَنْ عِنْدَهُ فِي قَلْبِهِ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّ مِنْ كِبْرِ. Prophet ﷺ said that whoever has like a small grain of arrogance and pride, he will never even smell Jannah. আমাদের মধ্যে যদি কোনো অহংকার এবং গৌরব সামান্য ন্যূনতম থেকে যায় সেটার জন্য আমরা জান্নাতের গ্রাণী আমরা পাবো না. And then people who have like also the racism and nationalism, I'm better just because my color, but just because of my race. আমি কিন্তু ভালো because আমার কাবিলা, আমার জাত, আমার বংশ, এই জন্য আমি ভালো. Again, another disease of the soul. And all of this thing need to be so clean and need to be purified. And let's not forget, actually the inward is much more important than outward. And this is the reason Prophet ﷺ said, "Attaqwa hahuna." When he mentioned about the taqwa, the God consciousness, the taqwa, kudabiru, Allah boy, ki, takon tuni bolchen, hahuna, hahuna, kalbar mudde, harder mudde, inside. But of course the outside is important too.
Now, we also mentioned about haya. Mm-hmm. Now, I just wanted to touch upon before we conclude. Now, we have seen yesterday was 14th of February. Now, mm-hmm. people are very proud, especially we have seen on news in Muslim countries, mm-hmm. that people who are not married are very proud of those sort of illicit or haram relationship. Mm-hmm. Now, what would your message be?
So again, haya is something that's really important, and it was taken seriously by all religions, and not only just Islam. Christianity and Judaism, mm-hmm. all religions, and it needs to be really upheld. And haya is a primary quality, and it's an important makarim al-akhlaq, part of the etiquette and character.
What I'm trying to get to is people feel proud of doing something that perhaps religiously or culturally is frowned upon, or perhaps even forbidden.
Yes. And Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, the wrong will be made right and right will be made wrong. And that will be a time like that. Just before we conclude, I wanted to mention, so tazkiyatun nafs is very important, and that can be achieved through the company of the good people, pious people, the people of piety, taqwa, and also through reading the books in spirituality. And that whole entire issue actually later on developed into something called tasawwuf. Of course, that's again a different subject, but some people have done extreme, or went to extreme on this, on the subject, and some people again have completely denied or rejected. But again, al-i'tidal is very, very important. But later on, tazkiyatun nafs transformed into a science called the ilm al-tasawwuf. But again, this has been taken misunderstood by some, and others completely rejected. So I believe at this time of the world, really in a materialistic world, at this time we really need to find a way to better ourselves. And the only way we can better ourselves is start from inside. And that's a reminder for myself. I need to do this. Every one of us, we're extremely in need of that. And we need to find a way to do that. And sometimes it can be through, the scholars, the people of spirituality, mentors, the people of tarbiyah.
How do you know people of spirituality?
Now, again, that's something that, you know, witness of people. For example, proved and measured by the Quran and Sunnah. Now we see, nobody is infallible, nobody is perfect, but when we see someone whose most of his actions are compatible and going and matching the Quran and Sunnah of the Noble Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, we can say that this person is a person of salah and taqwa, although we cannot guarantee, obviously, the najah for anybody, but still we can give the witness. Because Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he took the witness of people. Someone died and a janazah came, a funeral, and Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam asked, what do you think of that person? And then they said, he was bad. Prophet said, wajabat. He said, that's what happened. And then another janazah came to Prophet said, what do you think of that person? They said, he's good, very good. Prophet said, wajabat. So the witness of the people is very, very important. And so when people, majority of the people witness that this person is a person of spirituality, person
or known
of taqwa,
to be a person of spirituality.
And known, then he is or she is. And I think we need really help. And just the way we cannot achieve the academic knowledge, we also cannot achieve the taqwa without the help of the mentors and teachers.
So that means everything has to have a balanced approach.
Yes.
And we need to understand things in context. And if in doubt, should they not then consult the scholars or refer back to the Quran and Sunnah?
Yes, and yes, that's definitely true. And I normally say that it is easy to practice Islam. And Islam ke kintu amra ane amol kora kintu onek shohoj. But it is very difficult to balance it out.
Jazakallah
khair. All of those different branches of Islam.
Thank you very much. Our time is up. The hour is up. And inshallah, we hope to discuss more in our future coming episode. Thank you very much once again for coming down.
Allahi barik fikum.
With this, we have come to the conclusion of our tonight's discussion. We have discussed on purification of soul, one of the key aspects that the Shaykh have touched upon. There are two aspects to it. One is the internal and one is the external. Now, both needs to be focused at the same time. However, we should be very, very careful on putting importance in the right mind, with the right frame, and in the right things. Yes, we live in our 21st century, there's no problem with that. However, we need to always uphold the true values and teaching of Islam, and everything needs to be understood in context. If in doubt, do get in touch with a qualified local Islamic scholar who is knowledgeable on the scripture and in the sunnah, and will be, inshallah, be able to guide. Whatever opinion or discussion has been in this program, or opinion shared by the guest, is solely Sheikh's discussion and his thoughts. And inshallah, if you do have any question, please email us, and that is towardstheorigin@chsuk.tv. With this, we conclude, and inshallah, looking forward to see you again in our next week episode. Till then, subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.